Welcome to Cable Plus Property, your number one online educative platform on all issues related to land and landed property. My name is Oiza and it's so good to be here. At Cable Plus Property, our aim is to ensure that all Nigerians and non-Nigerians have at the tip of your finger every information related to land and landed properties. We provide you with all that you need to know about getting your landed property registered, obtaining your planning permits, land acquisition, documentation, and everything pertaining to land and landed properties. In this video, I'll be having an exciting and insightful session with a past chairman of the Nigerian Institute of Town Planners, Lagos State Chapter, from the year 2005 to 2007, no other than Town Planner Yusuf Sulaiman. Come with me. Good day. It's so good to have you on the show today.
Thank you very much.
Okay, before I get into the conversation, I'd like you to know who Town Planner Yusuf Sulaiman Alabi is. He was born in Lagos in the year 1951. He attended St. Joseph Primary School and Amadiya Grammar School for his higher school certificate, Amadiya College. And he also holds a professional diploma in urban and regional planning from the Polytechnic Ibadan, Oyo State, in 1978. He served in the National Youth Service Corps in 1979 at Kwara State Housing Corporation. Well, he joined the Lagos State Civil Service in 1979 as a town planner, grade 2. And he's had a successful career in the civil service and rose to the position of Director of Town Planning in the year 2000. He was later in 2005 appointed as the General Manager of Lagos State Physical Planning Development Authority, where he established the Physical Planning Intervention Department responsible for monitoring the building construction process and the removal of illegal development in Lagos State. Well, I'd like to take you through some of the awards he's won and the positions he's held. Like I said earlier, he is a past chairman of the Nigerian Institute of Town Planners, Lagos State Chapter. He is also he was also the vice president, Building Collapse Prevention Guide in 2019 to 2021. He was awarded the Nigerian Institute of Town Planners, Lagos State Chapter Merit Award in 2021. The Nigerian Institute of Building Lagos State Chapter 2009, the Franoli Incorporated Patriotic Achievers Award in 2007, the Nigerian Institute of Building Lagos State Chapter 2006, and amongst many other awards. So you would agree with me that he is nothing less than a professional. It's good to have you again, sir. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so let's get on to business, shall we? To a layman, how would you explain the planning profession if you are not to use some professional jargons now?
Thank you very much. Now, when we look at planning itself, planning is a discipline and it deals with beauty, deals with harmony, deals with sustainability through knowledge you acquire, the theory, and through practice that you are involved in. When you now look at the planning profession, the planning profession deals with the systemic organization of spaces. You talk about organizing your spaces, your land, your resources, your utilities, your services, in such a way that provide a suitable environment for living, working, and recreating. And you want to ensure that that community benefits from the aspect of planning. It's community-oriented.
Community-oriented is very important. Which body is responsible for regulating the practice of the professional?
By virtue of the federal government law, CAP T7, the Town Planning Registration Council of Nigeria is responsible for, you know, regulating the professional practice of town planners. So for you to be qualified, you have, after going to schools, to university or polytechnic or colleges that are recognized by the Nigerian Institute of Town Planners, and the TOPREC, that's the Town Planning Registration Council of Nigeria. You have another 2 years to spend. After that, then you can apply to the TOPREC for registration. Once they find you, you know, registrable, you are registered and you become a registered town planner.
Amongst other professions in the built environment, what impact has the building profession made, the planning profession, I beg your pardon, the planning profession made in the built environment?
You see, when you look at planning profession, it's more or less the bedrock upon which others build on. Because planning provides a broad spectrum through which the community, the city, the village, everything is seen. And they provide with a plan to work with. And so every other professional in the built industry will now key into that plan and ensure that it is realizable. So the idea behind the plan is that of the planners in relation to the people themselves and government, because there must be a reason behind the plan. So these reasons behind that plan, they are just, you know, developed, and then the planners work with them and then realize them through the preparation of those plans. So that's the responsibility of the planners in the within the built environment. And so when we plan, we also manage. It's in the area of management now and control that other professionals sees that we grant approval to various development in line with development plan prepared by town planners. So it is essential that all professional bodies key into the activities or the plan of town planners. Hmm. So we have to work together.
So you
say it's a teamwork.
The town planner is like the life wire of the built environment.
Definitely, it's the foundation. So without us providing the plan, there's nothing to build upon. Hmm. And it has to be well organized. So we take care of the organization of that space. Where should we have housing? Where should we have industry? Where should we have the drainage channel? Where should we have the airport? We determine that. It's only when we have determined, then other professionals will now come in. Okay, there's a space for housing. Then how can I design a house there? I have a plot here. It's for commercial. How could I get an architect develop a shopping mall for me, depending on the scale of this the land? So that's why planning is very key, very important.
Okay, we'd like you to educate our viewers on the different types of development plan, layout plan in particular.
Well, when we look at Nigeria as a whole, let's look at Nigeria as a case study. Development plans are meant to be guide, you know, towards your goal. At the national level, you're supposed to have the National Physical Development Plan that will give the country a focus of direction. What will be the direction of growth? The country as a whole. So that plan will look at all the states of the federation together, including Abuja, and then guide country on where to go. Where is the direction of growth? Where will we be looking for space for petrochemical development? Where should we be looking for spaces for the universities? You know, big institutions cited, all those things are taken care of in the National Physical Development Plan. And also, we talk about housing. What should be the housing dream of the federal government? These are related in the National Physical Development Plan. When you now come to the state has the prerogative to prepare what we refer to as the regional plan for the state. So in Lagos State, now we have a Lagos State regional plan that looks at the entire of Lagos State and then look at the different uses that will require of Then you talk about areas for agriculture, area for forestry, area for for housing, for industrials. All these are mapped out in that state regional plan, you know, at a very big scale, you know. Then when you come down, you look at all the local government, the local government level. You need to plan for local government, and within the local government, you're looking at the master plan for the local government. Each of the local governments is supposed to have a master plan, or what we refer to as a, what can also be called as the model city plan. Then you leave the local government, you come to a lower level of local government. You'll be thinking about, you know, district plan. Like a place like Osofe now, you can have a district plan. A place like Otuawori, you have a district plan at that level. And below that district plan, now we're talking about the town plan. All towns within the city need to have plans that will guide them, that will determine, okay, the housing type they want in that area, where should we have their commercial center, where should we have hospitals, where should we have a play area for the children. So at that level, all the towns need to have their plan. Then you go back to the villages. At the village level, they also have a guide. Something must guide them. If not, that will be what we call unplanned settlement. And the problem with unplanned settlement is that the inconsistency we have there, there are no harmony, and people have such a life that is not well coordinated, and people didn't really like it. The services are not there for them to enjoy. And so, as much as possible, every planner want to ensure that the state is more or less, you know, with less slum settlements. The lesser the slum settlement state, the better is the state. It means it's, you know, planning wise, you know, better off.
Okay, still on layout plan, particularly, who is the professional in the built environment that prepares the layout plan? And so this is like the two questions in one. And what are the components of the layout plan?
Now, for the layout plan, you're looking at the professional involved that need to prepare it. Yes, the only recognized professional that's supposed to prepare the layout plan is the registered town planner. By virtue of TOPREC, the Town Planning Registration Council law, that is the core area of town planners, and no other profession is expected to prepare a layout plan. And when you now look at what are the components you have in a layout plan is a lower level plan. And at that level, a lot of items are supposed to be recognized. You have a place for residential housing. You have plots of land. And these plots of land can also be, you know, more or less differentiated into different types. We have some that could be big plot size. You can have a medium size plot. You can have a small size plot, depending on the area of interest of the community. So that's why you could see that they have a land that could be about 60 by 120, you know, 30 by 120. You can have as big as 120 by 120, different sizes of plots. So within the same layout now, you can also have area that are being assigned for commercial, small commercial offices. You have a place for your retail outlet. You can have a place. Then you have, especially, that must be the road network, you know, that defines all other, you know, uses. You have your road network, you have your drainage plan, you know, you still have to also have a space for recreation. People where people can recreate, the children can play, the play area can be there, well defined, and then ensure that that is harmony between them. Then all other uses, you can have a place of worship, that will be properly located, that will not interfere with the community unnecessarily. So all these are details that you have in your residential, in your layout. Then this layout we talk about can be of different type. Now, as much many people will just know that we have a residential layout, there are also industrial layouts that set out areas where you have industrial concentration, and these are in terms of big sizes, and the facility to provide there too will relate to industrial development. You have big roads, big drainage, all those facilities to put in there will be measured for industrial development. Also, you have institutional layout. For the establishment of universities or polytechnic, you are compelled to prepare institutional layout, and these are prepared by professional town planners. You know, so these are the various type of layouts that you have, and it's only professional town planners that are mandated, that are allowed by law to prepare this layout, because they are trained for it. They are well trained for it, and they have the capacity to do that.
So when is a layout plan prepared?
Now, there are laws and regulations guiding preparation of layout. Like in Lagos State now, if you have a parcel of land that is 1 hectare of land, that's 2.5 acres of land. Once you have a land that is 2.5 acres of land, you are mandated by law to prepare a layout plan. So that means anything above from 2.5 acres of land, which is 1 hectare and above, it's compulsory before you can even get any approval of building plan to have a layout plan for that land. So
is it prepared before that? It's prepared before you even start to build at all?
Oh, definitely. You prepare your layout before starting to build, because at that level, that's what will guide you. There must be road. Okay? There must be drainage. All this must have been well set out before you can talk about having plots of land. And so your layout comes for before you get into building, you know, houses. But it is the layout that defines where your plots will be. Okay? So it is just very important that you must have a layout. And for those areas that doesn't have a layout, that's where we now have slums unplanned. That is between planned environment and unplanned environment. An unplanned environment will just come up on its own. People just be what they have. And what are the resultant effect? No road access. No road, no access. Footpath here and there. You can't bring a car into such environment. So a lot of problems associated with an unplanned area.
And yes, we rounded off with town planner Yusuf Sulaiman, and you'd agree with me that it's like no other. Don't forget to head onto our YouTube channel, subscribe to our YouTube channel at Cable Cross Property. Click the subscribe button just down below, like the video, share with friends and family, and also head onto other social media platforms, Instagram, Facebook, and follow us at Cable Cross Property. My name is Oiza, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.